seeing on your screens all the latest visuals of Cyclone Yaas. Joining me on the broadcast is my colleague Bhaskar to give us more on Cyclone Yaas. Bhaskar, do take us through the trajectory of the cyclone, because yesterday we had seen also the tornadoes that have hit the certain districts of West Bengal, causing a lot of damage. The airports have been shut now because of Cyclone Yaas, both in Odisha and West Bengal. Bhaskar, what more can you tell us with regards to the trajectory of Cyclone Yaas?
And this cyclone may hit the land after a few hours in Odisha, but the effect of this cyclone, the pre-landfall effects, are already we can see here. Right now I am just in front of a village of Mausuni Island, and here all you can see the structures which were built to restrict the water to enter inside the village. All those structures are getting broken down, and the waters are getting locked again inside the village. And all those people who are the local residents, all those kids, all those young people, all those aged people are trying desperately to fight against this cyclone. And as you can see just behind my back, there is Mausuni Island, a famous tourist spot in West Bengal, in South Chobbish Parganas. And right now it's already been waterlogged, and all of the area, you can see the water levels are getting getting high and high with the time. And the cyclone hadn't made the landfall yet, but the situation is getting worse. In the previous year, Cyclone Amphan did a devastating damage in all over the place. And this time, Cyclone Yaas, which is all set to make its landfall in Odisha, but the situation in here, the situation in South Chobbish Parganas, the situation in Mausuni Island, Bokdip, Kakhali, Kakdip, Bokkhali, everywhere, the situation is like Amphan. But the local people, all those people who are fighting this water, are saying that the devastating situation of Amphan they had seen, and thus, right now the situation is much more devastating than the Amphan. And they are almost helpless, and the local administration are not helping them properly, and so that they are fighting all on their own. And just look at this side. I would ask my video journalist Meras to show all the pictures and show all the ground reality of here in West Bengal, here in South Chobbish Parganas, that all the areas are getting flooded by the water, and the water levels are gradually increasing, and the trees are also getting drowned in water, and the cyclone would make much worse effect after its landfall. And so that the local people, the local residents, the people of Bengal are already getting tensed that after making its landfall, the cyclone Yaas will show its effect here in South Chobbish Parganas, here in Bengal. And before landfall, this is the current situation, this is the ground reality of South Chobbish Parganas, just beside Mausuni Island. And after the landfall, the rain will increase gradually, and the gusty winds also get increased, and the rescue ops or the fights of these kids will get much more tough. And what should they do now? What should they do? They are trying to fight. And just look at this kid. Just look at this kid. We are showing you from the very ground, and he is shivering from cold. But although he is shivering, he is in pain, but he is trying to fight as much as he can to resist the water, to get inside the village, and not to get waterlogged, not to get flooded by this rain, by this water. Right now, they are fighting an inhuman fight. They are fighting a giant. They are fighting this water. They are fighting Cyclone Yaas, which is ought to be made its landfall after a few hours.
Bhaskar, you take care of yourself as Cyclone Yaas makes that landfall. You take care of yourself. Also, the fishermen, they're securing their boats. It's a double whammy for West Bengal with the COVID pandemic hitting the state as well.